In the coming weeks, the reality of the impact of coronavirus pandemic on education will play out in Nigeria as the federal government and state governors have ordered the closure of both public and private institutions. This is to curtail the spread of COVID-19, which in recent times has reshaped human activities across the world. And now, Folawe Omikunle, CEO Teach for Nigeria, joins us live in the studio to look at the impact of COVID-19 on education, challenges ahead of the teachers and school administrators. Thank you for joining us on News on the Hour.
Thank you very much.
Now, as an educationist, let's look at the impact of this, how it's affected the education sector and the closures of schools as it's been done of late.
So just a week ago, once my team and myself started to assess this impact of COVID-19, initially none of the states had started shutting down schools yet. Everything was still going on as business as usual, but we could see, you know, in other parts of the world, this already started. And so it was just last week when we started, it was the northwestern states that first of all started holding the meetings to decide to shut down the schools. And I think just as it's important, the safety of the children, the safety of the teachers, and the safety of the community comes first. So I think it's definitely the right step in the right direction. Now, I work in a space where I deal with public children who attend public schools. Right. And so we have kids who obviously do not have access to any other form of education, but having their teacher in the classroom and attending school on a daily basis. And so when I think about that and the impact, it's that we're going to have kids who are going to be home for several months and who wouldn't be learning. And so it's to say, what are the innovative methods? I think one of the things that this is allowing for us to do, especially states like Ogun State and in Lagos State, they're thinking innovatively and creatively to say, how can we provide, you know, how can learning continue even during this period? So a lot of them are leveraging radio, they're pre-recording lessons, they're thinking about how to leverage, you know, load up materials onto, you know, online portals. They're thinking about how to still continue to prepare the final year SS3 students for the exams. And so, you know, that is something that is happening and a lot of states are talking about. Right. But at the same time, we have teachers, a lot of teachers who might not be equipped to assess these platforms or to leverage and use these platforms. We're also having parents who are not able to, you know, guide their children through this or support their children through this. So there are lots of gaps and a lot of lapses. Okay. But I think this is also where I've seen a lot of messages where they're sharing with parents, educating them on how to support their children through this learning period. You know, their phone calls being placed to parents to say, this is how you can engage your wards and this is how you can monitor the progress of what is happening and how they're learning. And when I think about the universities also being shut down, I think this is a time for, you know, much more advanced learners to think about, how do I acquire skills? Education in itself, it's not just the content and the subject, but it's also the skills. You can learn the new language during this period. You can take that new certifying exam this period. You can learn something, learn skills. You can watch the YouTube videos to learn different things and equip yourself and develop yourself during this period.
Oh, and that's on the side of the pupils, the students. Now, let's look at the teachers now and the school administrators. Mm. What impact do you think this might have on them?
Well, I think for a lot of people, I think it's going to be a mixed bag. I think there are people who are literally going to be redundant, but I think there are also a group of people who are going to take this as an opportunity to reinvent and innovate. Some of the best ideas and the most creative ideas have come during crises like this. Some of the best platforms and innovations have come during crises like this. And so I'm engaged in platforms and groups where teachers and administrators are thinking, you know what, how can we gather ourselves and start to design instructional materials and content that could be pre-recorded and that could be aired on radio or on local TV? How can we, you know, pre-record videos that could be placed on YouTube and that could, you know, so that children can have access to this for those who have internet? And so I'm part of groups and I'm part of conversations where principals and administrators and teachers are talking about, you know, this sort of interventions and innovation. But I'm sure there'll be a group who will literally just, you know, cross their legs at home and not really think about how to problem solve and how to further support their students to continue to learn. But I'm much more encouraged by what I'm seeing, and to even see that that is happening in Nigeria and it's happening at this scale, you know, so urgently. I think people are recognizing just the importance of, you know, ensuring that our children are just not left at home not doing anything during this period.
Let's look at the academic calendar. I know there's an academic calendar. So how much of that will be affected by this?
Well, it's drastically going to be affected. said. I mean, you already see with the exam boards as well, they're pushing, you know, postponing, calling off and cancelling exams. And it's being called off until further notice. So the entire calendar is going to be affected. Now, how it will be affected, I don't have that details because it's such an uncertain period for everyone. And so we can't really make definite plans. And so we're just really going to watch and watch as this COVID goes away. But you know, everything is being affected and it's drastically going to affect the school calendar as well.
Now, prior to the closure of most schools, both primary, secondary and tertiary school, how informed and equipped do you think the teachers were on safety measures, hygiene measures to curtail the spread of this virus?
So this was something that a lot of people weren't expecting. Yes. But I think, you know, in Nigeria, one of the things that I saw happen, especially in the states that I'm working with, is that as soon as we started to, as soon as we got our first case, everybody sat up, you know, so you could see the messages. People were drawing up chats. They were having, you know, they were coming up with songs to reiterate to their students to wash their hands, you know, not touch their faces, to stand 3 feet away from one another, to practice social distancing. And so we saw a lot of that happen. And I think it's still one of the things that I think needs to happen, because there's still some group of people with the mindset that, you know, this isn't for us. We are not able to get infected. But I think the government needs to amplify this advocacy and the messaging. But in terms of school, from where I am sitting from, I saw a lot of people who got up and started to, you know, share and make all these campaign materials around what is needed to do to prevent, you know, the spread of this disease.
All right, Folawe, just before I let you go this afternoon, what would be your advice? What's your word out there to both parents, teachers, school administrators during this period where the schools are closed?
So one of the things that I've always said is that, you know, for education to be successful, it's a tripod. And so there is the school system, there is the student, and there is the parent. I think for the longest time, a lot of parents had absolved their responsibilities to the school. But now is the time for parents to sit up, get up, and play their part and support the school and support their children to keep learning during this period. It's not going to last forever. So I think people should stop panicking. We should just adhere to the instructions and continue to support our children during this difficult phase and this very trying period for everyone across the world.
Folawe Omikunle, CEO Teach for Nigeria, thank you very much for joining us on
Thank
News
you
on the
for
Hour.
Having me.